Hey, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Midwest Miniature Guys Sunday night super chill stream. How you all doing? Hope you're doing well. For some reason, it's saying that I am unstable tonight. We'll see if we can change that. Hope you all are doing well. I hope you're having a good weekend. Hope that we're gonna reload the player here. Apparently, that didn't work. There we go. We went to, it's been a weekend. Friday was great. We went and saw one of our favorite bands play down at the Dubliner Pub. Go by the Langer's Ball, which was a ton of fun. I got to see some people that we hadn't seen in a while as well. So that was cool. Then yesterday was clean up the garage and clean up my basement studio day. And as we all know, I'm getting older. And as you all know, I don't have the greatest of backs. Well, I loaded all of my big drums back downstairs yesterday, along with pushing the old righty lawnmower out to the curb, which then Kim came out and helped me do that like a quarter of the way done. And then I maneuvered it to make sure that it was away from the fire hydrant that's on the corner of our the yard. And while I was moving the drums downstairs, I felt a twinge in my back. And I'm like, yep, this is where I start hurting. And sure enough, after I got everything done, and I got everything set back up the way it's supposed to be set up, my back is screwed. So I was hurting all night last night. I painted for a little while yesterday, just trying to get a couple of things done. And then I was like, nope, I can't do this anymore. I have to go upstairs and take a couple of muscle relaxers, which I did, and I ended up falling asleep at like 10:30 last night. I didn't wake up till almost 10:30 this morning. So obviously I needed the sleep. But my back felt okay today. Now, we went to Chalk Fest today in Maple Grove, which is a ton of fun, and I saw some really cool pieces. But my back only takes so much, and after about an hour of walking around, I was like, I gotta go sit down. And Kim had already wandered off. She likes to stop and look at each piece and talk to the artist and blah, 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 which I normally do myself, but brain and body wasn't in it today. So I went and sat down and just people watched for the rest of the day, and which is fine. But she was like, hey, Kim's like, hey, do you want to go to Broadway Pizza, which is right here on the corner of this, where right across the street from where you're sitting? And I said, I think they have like an hour and a half wait. And she's like, really? And I said, yeah. So she goes in and talks to the folks, and they're like, yep, we have about an hour and a half to get in. She's like, you have five tables behind you that are open. How is that an hour and a half? Just is. Bye. Thanks for coming in. And so we didn't go there, and we went elsewhere and had leper, and then came home and got cleaned up for the week. And now I'm here, and we're gonna paint some stuff. So we are continuing work on the Tyranid Hybrid. I've also been working on some other minis that I cleaned up yesterday, and I found a bunch of figures that I completely forgot that I had. So my drawer of opportunity flows over once again, because I took a lot of the stuff that were in these boxes and put them in my drawer so I could grab at will kind of whatever I wanted, you know, wanted to paint, or, you know, whatever I grabbed. What was the next piece of opportunity to grab? So let's go ahead and get started here. This is where we left off with the body of the Tyranid. We still need to do mid-tones on what I call the fleshy bits. I guess suppose we could have done that bone as well, but didn't want to. Just wanted the carapace to be bone. We still got to work on the carapace. We're going to put on a highlight of bright ivory and then maybe mix a little white into that and do that as well. So we're gonna work on that. This is another piece that I've been working on. This is the Phoenix from Reaper Miniatures. So far, mostly painted with contrast paints, and then I grabbed a little bit of coal black for the tips of the wings, a little bit of bold titanium white for the belly and the beak, and we'll kind of go from there. I don't know if there's any more I want to do with the beak, but we'll see. But yeah, that's kind of where we're at with that. And I have a bunch of stuff just kind of piled on my paint desk right now. Quick shout-outs here for some folks that have recently followed. I don't know why, but Casey keeps either unfollowing me or and then following me back. But Casey Holt Mini Paint has followed me again. Fatso followed 3 days ago. Toast Minnesota followed me yesterday, and Jarlax the Rogue followed me 3 hours ago. So thank you all for the new follows. We're at 438 of our 440 goal, so that's super cool. So if you know folks that like mini painting, come check us out. We got a few people watching tonight. Hello, everybody. Good evening. Put that away. Put it away. Put it away. Put it away now. Where's my bright? There's my bright ivory. Yeah, maybe. The nice thing about doing highlights here now is that we're literally just kind of picking out certain little areas, especially once we add a little bit of white into this, is that we're just picking at the highest highlights here. We don't have to go over every single little bit. We're just gonna lightly pick out some areas here. So as usual, if you ever have any questions or whatever, throw them up in the chat. I'll be happy to answer those for you. Or if you're watching on YouTube, put them in the comments. I will answer you as quickly as I possibly can. All right, we're just gonna go right straight down the back here. Sorry, my nose had a little whistle. Trying to get rid of it. Looks like these two. These two over here. Let's take a look here. Looks pretty good. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a little bit of white, highlight some edges, and then we should be calling the carapace part anyway, done. Okay, that's all we're gonna do for the white. We're done there. Like our blue black. Where is our, that's our dark gray blue. This stuff right here is honestly why a lot of folks dry brush. Because it's like, I just want to get this done. Or they use an airbrush. Player is not working. Nope, it's just not working. try reloading this again. Hold on. Little spider just dropped right down in front of me. Yuck. Okay, I got that arm done. I need to move this one here. This is just the mid-tones that we're putting on. We're actually gonna highlight this up as well. Probably not as high. We'll probably just go with straight up dark blue gray, but we are going to highlight. And just go up just a tad bit. So probably instead of doing the dark gray blue, I'll probably add a little bit of light gray or even white into our mix. think we got all of our kind of dark blue gray done there. Alright, I mixed in a little bit of ivory and white to give us kind of more of a blue-gray. Lighter blue-gray anyway. See how much of this we actually get highlighted. So a lot of this is going to be in shadow with him sitting there like that. So I'm going to take a look here. Zenithal highlighting at its finest. This for sure. be this one here. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, see, we did a little bit more gray here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this blue gray The most. What's going on? Stepping in for a few minutes to say howdy. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Is that a Sharky? What's happening? Tyranid? Yes. Working on a Tyranid abomination for my D&D game, actually. He's going to represent a... an experimented on hook horror. So that's what we're currently working on right now. And the cool thing is he's got a magnetic head. So I could replace it with any of these. I've got three other heads. The other one looks vaguely similar. Right, open mouth, stuff like that. Still pretty cool. Might paint them up the same way. The other two are... You like that idea? Yeah. The other two are alien predator hybrids heads. So you can see the predator mandibles here with the alien little... let's see if we can get it in the camera here. A little mouth come out here. So, yeah. But right now, I've just been working on this one. I like the color scheme that we came up with here on stream. Chomper thingy. Yep. And I think this is gonna scare the crap out of my players when I throw that down on the table. I got a little bit more bright ivory and white mix here. Because I definitely want another highlight. Maybe not that bright, though. More like that. I hope you folks are doing well tonight. Always good to see you in chat. Doing well. What about me? I'm doing all right. I messed my back up yesterday, so I'm in a little bit of pain. But other than that, I'm doing okay. Right now, I'm just chilling. Back isn't hurting a whole lot right now, which means the pain meds have kicked in. I think it helped that I got out and walked a little bit today. I wasn't sure if I was going to be too keen on doing that, but we went to a chalk festival today where folks were doing chalk art on the street. They had the street all blocked off for like the last couple days, and they were doing chalk art on it. And this isn't just like little kids, making chalk art or whatever. It's like professional chalk artists doing the art. And it was cool. It was cool to see. Other than that, just trying to prepare myself for the onslaught of Monday. As I'm sure quite a few of us are. And hoping that the week goes by quickly so we can get to Friday, because then my band goes back in the studio on Friday to finish up guitar solos and vocals for our new album. So I'm excited to get to the end of the week so we can get that finished up so that they can start mixing and mastering, and we can have a new album out by halfway to St. Patrick's Day, which will be super cool. A great person once said, and I shall quote, just hit it again. It will make the pain go away. Granted, new pain will be replaced. However, the original pain will be gone. So hit it again. Yeah. No. I'm good. I'd rather not. I've got enough pain in my body for everybody in stream. So I don't. I don't need to deal with that. I'd rather not. And correct me if I'm wrong, isn't that quote from The Lion King? I seem to remember the old wise bamboo. I can't remember his name. Rafiki, that was his name. Doing that to Simba when Simba was grown. I quoted a random guy who quoted something else. Could be. Okay. 39. Okay. Hey, Myth Dusters, what's going on? How's it going? It's going well. This looks fantastic. Thank you. Love the color choices. I appreciate that. The chat kind of helped me pick out the color choices last Monday or Wednesday, I think it was. It is a Tyranid for Warhammer 40K. However, I'm going to be using it as a experimented on hook horror for D&D. Hence why it's got the four arms, no eyes, just this wicked looking carapace. I believe they call it a screamer in 40K. But the head, I have got a bunch of heads, and this one here, they're magnetized, so it's gonna look. Sharky says, not gonna lie, the back honestly reminds me of a tortoise shell, a war tortoise shell. Yeah, it's kind of probably what they were going for with the armor piece up here, but I wanted that those contrasting colors. Between the really dark gray blues and the bright ivory bone pieces. Miss says, not used to seeing you wear gloves for these, must be because of the types of paint. It's not because of the types of paint, it's actually because I don't have a holder to put this on, and I don't want the oils of my fingers getting on the model because I've been holding it like this, or like this, but I'm still like bracing it, so, and I also don't want to rub any paint off, and these gloves will help with that. Now we're going to take a little bit of this white and ivory mix here. If you see any of these little things like this here, I'm just going to run a little bit in through there. Because I'm going to use some contrast paint to put an extra little bit of color on this guy. How many days is this? We're working on hours 3 and 4 right now. We're closing in on 4 hours of work. Well, I add blood or dings from hits to this. No, probably not. I try to keep most of my paint jobs fairly clean, unless the client asks for that. Since I'm painting this for myself, I kind of want to keep it natural. If I was going to, I would get some hot glue and do some drips once I got the base done, so it looked like it was dripping down onto the ground, and do like a pool of it from the mouth, and do like maybe a sickly green. But that's about the only thing I would really do. Since they haven't made contact with this creature yet, they don't even know what it is. And the creature may have not been in any fights yet. So yeah, you're imagining way more than 4 hours now? About almost closing on four. 10 o'clock will be 4 hours. We painted the head up pretty quickly when we first started, so. How many colors just for the white parts? It is probably about four. I think it's four or five colors for the white parts. It's about three or four colors for the kind of blue-gray parts. Fix that part there. this or do I need to do the... Oh, we got the other side there. The other little bits. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna do. How is married life for my daughter? She is doing well. Thank you for asking. They are actually up at a friend of theirs' cabin this weekend. They were doing some fishing, and they've been catching northern pike. They were doing some trolling, so she's pretty excited about learning how to do that. All right, so now we're going to take a little bit of Volupus pink here, which is what we did for the tendons and gum section right there in the tongue. And we're just going to run this in the areas that we painted that off-white. I just have the one child, just the one kiddo. Yep, just the one with my wife. Band is going well. We went into the studio on Memorial Day weekend and started the process of recording a new album. We'll go back in this Friday to finish it. And then we should have it available by halfway to St. Patrick's Day, which is September... Well, it's September 17th, but we're playing a gig on the 14th, so we're going to release it then. Yes, yeah, St. Patrick's Day is in March, but halfway to St. Patrick's Day is September 17th. It's literally 6 months away, so there's actually a celebration called Halfway to St. Patrick's Day that a lot of Irish pubs celebrate. Yeah, firmly aware that St. Patrick's Day is in March. That's our busy season. Well, you just heard about it here. You never heard of celebrating halfway to St. Patrick's Day. That's a thing. Sort of, yeah. Sort of like celebrating Christmas in July. Any week plans? No, just the job. Trying to finish this up. Then move on to something else. It's kind of the week plans right now. Next weekend is Father's Day, so I'll be spending time with my daughter and her husband out on a boat fishing. So I'm looking forward to doing that. So they probably won't be a stream next Sunday, because I don't think I want to come home and do that. Gonna be a long day, so. Probably no stream next week. Or, yeah, next Sunday anyway. But we'll see. Depends on how good the fish are biting and when I get home. Miss says, a friend earlier this week asked me to see the new Planet of the Apes film in theaters. On Wednesday, it was nice going with only two other groups in the theater. Oh, nice. On the boat fishing sounds fun. Are you going to the Great Lakes to fish? No, we're not going up to Superior, though that would be a ton of fun. We are going to a lake that's like 5 or 10 minutes from their house. I hear it's really good. They said it's been a lot of fun, and I think we're going to be taking her father-in-law with us as well. And I really like her father-in-law. Super nice guy. So, it'll be fun. Hopefully, we can get him out of the house and out in the boat fishing. I think that's it. I don't think I want to do anything else to this. It's just going to be a gaming piece. I do want to do, a base. I gotta create a base for it. I think I'll do that off stream, and then anybody's interested, they can go check out the social medias. Get that done. But yeah, other than that, our Tyranid hybrid hook horror thingy is done. Good enough for gaming, is what I say. About 4 hours work on that. Last week was vacation Bible school at my church, and it was Jungle Cruise themed. Oh, that's cool. So this is the Phoenix that I've also been working on. This is a metal pewter figure from Reaper Miniatures. I'm just going to do a couple quick little things on here, and then it'll be done. Your museum is having a kids camp this weekend. Oh, neat. I remember those always being fairly fun times of going to a museum, or I remember going to Grand Coulee Dam in Washington State as a kid and getting to see all the cool the fish ladders that help the fish go up the river. That was neat. We also got to go to the University of Washington, or excuse me, the University, Washington State University, WSU. We went there. We went to th through their agricultural facilities, and we got to see the world's first horse prosthetic. Of course, that was back in 86 or 87. So that was kind of cool. It was like this, high-tech polymer, type of a thing that instead of having to put the horse down, they just took the horse's foot, fore leg off, and then put this prosthetic on. And the horse was able to walk, able to run, able, it was just super cool. We're just going to grab a little bit of a green contrast here and just eyes. All right, so this is done. So yeah, there's our Phoenix. That's done. Thank you. Yeah. Quick little paint job on that. Oh, let's see. So this is just corkboard, very thin corkboard. I'm just breaking pieces off of it here. So this is what I'm going to use for the base of our Tyranid here. That way. Got a couple big pieces here. If they get too big, I'll break them apart. Section. I can also build it up like that. What I don't want to do is just have to use a bunch of technical paint and put it all down and just make it look like one big gloppy mess. I actually want there to be some kind of form to this. Yeah, I kind of like that. We use the accelerant here to speed up the drying process of that glue. We're going to let that set overnight and then we'll paint it. Actually, we'll start putting on the technical paint around it. Tomorrow. Well, I think that's about it for tonight, folks. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if we can raid into anybody. If there's anybody streaming right now. We're gonna raid into Scarlet Rose Plays. She is playing Senior Deputy Zoe Winters on Wild RP. Give her some love, folks. And I will see you all tomorrow, where we'll work on the base for that Tyranid, along with a couple other things. So, hope you all have a wonderful rest of your evening, and we will see you tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Have a good one, folks. Bye.